早晨咁多位，欢迎大家翻返嚟我 Learn with Tom Lee 嘅教室，亦都系 A Level 嘅课堂。今堂将会系新嘅一个 Chapter 8第八课 Parametric Equation 参数方程式。首先我哋睇睇什么是 Parametric Equation。第八课我哋将会讲到 Parametric Equation 8.1 至到 8.5 节，当然 8.6 节就会系一个 mix 嘅 exercise。8.1 节 Parametric Equation。8.2 Using Trigonometric Identity in Parametric Equation 8.3 Curve Sketching 8.4 Points of Intersection 8.5 Modeling with Parametric Equation 然後 8.6 Mixed Exercise Summarize 整個 Chapter 8的 Parametric Equation You can write the X and Y coordinates of each point on the curve as function of first variable This variable is called a parameterand is often represented by the letter t. A curve can be defined using parametric equation x 等于 p of t, 即是 x 等于一个 function of t, and y 等于 q of t, 亦都是另外一个 function of t. Each value of the parameters t define a point on the curve with coordinate pt and qt. 所谓 parametric equation 就是我们会有 x 和 y, 但 x 和 y 没有直接的关系的。x 是一个 t 的 function, 而 y 亦都是一个 t 的 function。我哋 sketch 个 graph 出嚟嘅时候啦，嗰条 curve 上面嘅每一个 point 咧，将会系 pt 同埋 qt 嘅。我哋睇睇下低呢个例子 ，x 等于 t square 加一除俾 t，y 等于 2t， 而 t 系大过零。当 t 等于2嘅时候啦 ，x 就会等于2嘅 square 加一除俾2，即系 2.5， 而 y 就系等于4。咁我哋將 x 同埋 y 嘅關係喺呢個 Cartesian coordinate system 裏面啦 ，x 等於 2.5 嘅時候啦 ，y 就係等於 4， 所以我哋畫到呢個 point 2.5 同埋 4。如果 t 係 0.5，x 就係 2.5，y 咧就會係 1， 所以我哋就會有 2.5 同埋1呢個 point。跟住我哋每一個 t， 我哋都畫一個 point 出嚟。當然個 t 係大過0啦，我哋就會畫到呢條 curve。呢條 curve 就係叫做 parametric equation。You can converse between parametric equation and the Cartesian equation by using substitution to eliminate the parameter。呢句説話就好似呢個例子咁樣，亦即係話 t 就會等於幾多個 x， 然之後我 substitute 翻落去個 equation 裏邊，我哋就會計到 y 係等於幾多個 x。For parametric equation， x 等於 pt and y 等於 qt with the Cartesian equation。y is a function of x, y 就会可以写成 function of x, 只要我们将 x 等于几多个 t 写返成 t 等于几多个 x, 然后代返落去 y 和 t 之间的关系就会将个 t eliminate 咗出来就会形成咗 y 和 x 之间的关系。The domains of fx, 而这个 fx 的 domain 呢就是 pt 的 range, 就是这个 pt 的 range, 而 fx 的 range 就是 qt 的range 这个就是一连串的定义我们看看一些的例子让大家可以明白到 parametric equation 怎么变成一个 Cartesian equation y 等于 fx A curve has the parametric equation x 等于 2t y 等于 t square 而 t 是由负3至到3 Find a Cartesian equation of the curve in the form y equal to fx 首先我们拿x 等于 2t, 我们就会计到 t 就等于 x 除比 2,t 等于 x 除比 2, 代返入去这个的 y 等于 t square, 我们就会有 y 等于 t square, 代个 x 除比 2, 所以是 x 除比2的 square, 亦即是 x square 除比 4, 我们就会计到 y 等于 x square 除比 4. State the domain and range of fx, 个 domain of fx 的亦即是个 range of pt 所以当 t 是由负3至到3 the domains of fx 就会由负6至到6因为我们 x 等于 2t 那这个 x 呢也就是 2t t 是等于负3去到3 2t 就当然是负6去到6我们就会得出这个 t 是等于负3去到 t 个 domain of fx 就是负6去到6而个 range of fx 呢我哋就将个 t 系代负3至到个 t 系等于3你会发觉 t 系负3嘅时候 ，y 会系9 t 系3嘅时候 ，y 亦都系9 喺咩情况之下 ,y 会系最小啦，当个 t 系等于0嘅时候啦，0嘅 square 就系 0,y 就会等于 0, 即系 y 最小都要系 0, 个 fx 嘅 range 亦即系 y 系由0去到 9, 所以就会系大过等于 0, 小过 9, 我哋就会揾到个 range 同埋个 domain of fx。记住 ,y 就系个 range of fx, 而 x 啦就是个 domain of fx。第三条 ,sketch a curve within the given domain for t, 画返呢个 curve 出嚟。你要见到我哋画返条 curve 出嚟啦，就係当个 x 系由负6去到 6, 所以 x 系负6嘅时候啦 ,y 就会系等于 9,x 系0嘅时候啦就 y 等于 0,x 等于6嘅时候啦 ,y 就会系等于 9, 咁所以我哋条 curve 啦就变咗咁样嘅条 curve。我哋就會 sketch 咗呢條 curve 出嚟啦。我哋睇睇第二條嘅例子 ，a curve has a parametric equation x 等於 log t 加3 y 係等於1除俾 t 加5 t 係大過負二。Find the Cartesian equation of the curve of the form y 等於 f(x), 而 x 係大過 k, where k is the constant to be found。咁我哋要揾翻呢個 k 呢個 value 係等於幾多 ？B write down the range of fx, 我哋都计个 range of fx, 记住 the range of fx 啦，亦即系 the range of qt。我哋有嘅题目就系 x 等于 log t 加3 y 等于一除俾 t 加5 t 大过负二。A 我哋就要揾翻个 Cartesian equation of the form y 等于 fx 同埋 x 系大过一个数字 k 嘅。当 x 等于 log t 加3，亦即系e of x 等于 t 加3，而 t 就会系等于 ex 减俾3。我将个 ex 次方减俾3代翻入去呢个 y 等于 qt 里边，我哋就会得出 y 等于一除俾 t 加5，亦即系一除俾 ex 减3加5，亦即系一除俾 ex 加2。when t 等于负二。当个 t 等于负二，因为 t 系大过负二，当个 t 等于负二嘅话呢、这个就会是 log 一 ，log 一亦即系零，个 x 就会是零。as t increase log t 加三 increase， 如果个 t 越嚟越大，负一零一二三四个 t 越嚟越大啦，呢、这、一个数字 log t 加三啦，亦都会越嚟越大。so the range of the parametric function for x is x 大过零。因为 x 是等于0已经是最小的 value 了，个 t 是等于负二。当个 t 是越来越大的时候，个 x 当然都会越来越大，所以0是个 minimum domain of fx 将会是 x 大过0。The Cartesian equation is y 等于一除比 ex 加二，而 x 是一定要大过0。B write down the range of fx， 我要写低个 range of fx。range of fx 其实亦即系呢个 y 嘅 range。t 等于负二嘅时候 ，y 就等于一除俾 t 加五，就一除俾三。但系当个 t 一路路增加嘅时候咧，个 y 就会一路减少，因为呢个分母越大嘅时候，成个分数咧就会越嚟越细。But it's always positive， 永远都系正数。因为这个永远都是正数，去不到负数的。So the range of the parametric function for y is y 是大过零，因为永远是正数，而一定是小过三分一的了。因为 t 等于负二的时候 ，y 的 value 已经是最大，所以一定是小过三分一。The range of fx is y from 0 to 三分一，但永远不去到 0， 因为这个数字无论几大都好。这个 y 啦，永远都不会等于零，可以去到好细好细，但系永远都不会等于零，所以是不会等于零，只是大过零，亦都永远不会大过三分一，因为这个 t 啦，一路去到负二已经是最尽，它没有掂到负二，只要掂到负二啦，它就是三分一，但系冇掂到负二，所以它会是小过三分一，而不是小过等于三分一噶。过了这两条的例子。我哋一齐嚟做 exercise， 大家准备好纸笔同埋计数机。我哋做嘅 exercise 包括咗第三条有 A B C D E F 六个细题，第四条会有 A 同埋 B， 第五条会有条 curve， 然之后我哋做翻 A、B、C 嘅答案。咁呢度牵涉到一个微分嘅，就系 dy by dt。咁我慢慢咧喺下一堂开始，即系第九课开始啦，就开始讲到微分。啊呢度咧就牵涉咗少少微分，我系暂时当大家识咗微分嘅某部分，我会介绍俾大家知道噶啦。跟住同埋第六条就会有 A 同埋 B 两部分。准备好，我哋开始啦。
Question number three, find a catastrophic equation for each of these parametric equations. Given your answer in the form of y equal to fx. In each case, find the domain and the range of fx. So as we have x equal to t minus 2, so t equal to x plus 2. We substitute t equal to x plus 2 into this equation. We got y equal to x plus 2.to the square plus 1 equal to x square plus 4x plus 4 plus 1 is equal to x square plus 4x plus 5. So we got the function of y equal to fx where it is equal to x square plus 4x plus 5. And the domain of this is just when t equal to minus 4, x is equal to minus 6.And when t equal to positive 4, x is equal to 2. So the domains of this function should be x is greater or equal to minus 6 and less than or equal to 2. This is the domain. And the range is that when t is equal to 0, y is minimum and y is equal to 1. When tincrease, y increase. Therefore, the range of y equal to fx equal to x squared plus 4x plus 5y is greater than or equal to 1. Of course, it's to infinity.This is the range of fx. And question B, x equal to 5 minus t. We got t is equal to 5 minus x. And we substitute t equal to minus x into this equation. We got y equal to 5 minus x squared plus 1. So we got it's 25 minus 10x.Plus x squared plus 1. So it's equal to x squared minus 10x plus 26. This is the function. When we put a real number into here, and we got also x is belong to a real number. So we get the function y equal to fx equal to x squared minus 10x plus 26, and x belong to real number.So if we want to find the range of this function, y equal to fx equal to x squared minus 10x plus 26, when t is equal to 0, y is minimum. So y is equal to 1. So y, the minimum y is 1. Therefore, the range of this function is y greater thanor equal to 1. Of course, y is also belong to real number. Question 3c. X equal to 1 over t, y equal to 3 minus t. T is not equal to 0. So we got t equal to 1 over x. And we substitute t equal to 1 over x into this equation. We get y equal to 3 minus 1.Over x is equal to 3x minus 1 over x. We got this equation here. And the domain of this is when t is not equal to 0, that means this one is not equal to 1 over 0. So t, that means this one is a positive or a negative number, right? So it's never be 0 here also. So xis not equal to 0 also. This is the domain of this function. And the range of this function is y equal to 3x minus 1 for x, when t is not equal to 0, that means y is not equal to 3. Because this one is, if it's equal to 0, y is equal to 3. So we got the range of y is not equal to 3. Here's the range, and this is the domain of this function. And d part, x equal to 2t plus 1, y equal 1 over t. T is greater than 0. We have 2t equal to x minus 1 and t equal to x minus 1 over 2. We substitute into this equation here. So we got y equal to 1 over x minus 1 over 2 is equal to 2 over x minus 1. Got the function y equal to fx and equal to 2 over x minus 1. When t is greater than 0, this means x is always greater than 1. So x is greater than 1. When t is greater than 0, this means this is a positive number. So y is greater than 0 as well, because it's from infinity to 0. So the y is also greater than 0 here. Question number 3e, x equal to 1 over t minus 2 and y equal to t squared. If t is always greater than 2, we get this 2t minus 2 equal to 1 over x. So we got t equal to 1 over x plus 2. So t is equal to 1 plus 2x over x. We substitute t equal to 1 plus 2x over x into this equation. We got y equal to 1 plus 2x over x to the square. So we found that y equal to fx is equal to 1 plus 2x over x to square. And the domains of this function is that when t is equal to 2, this one is undefined. But t is always greater than 2, so x is always greater than 0. So we got x always greater than 0 here. And how about the range of this function? We got y equal to fx equal to 1 plus 2x over x. The range of this function is when t is greater than 2, that means y is always greater than 4. So y is greater than 4 here. It got the range of this function and the domain of this function. Question number 3f. We got x equal to 1 over x equal to 1 over t plus 1. And y is equal to 1 over t minus 2. And t is always greater than 2. So we got here t plus 1 equal to 1 over x. So t is equal to 1 over x minus 1. So t is equal to 1 minus x over x. We substitute t equal to 1 minus x over x into this equation. We got y equal to 1 over 1 minus x over x minus 2. We have here 1 over 1 minus x minus 2x over x. And we have y equal to x over 1 minus 3x. So we got fx equal to x over 1 minus 3x. So what is the domains of this function here? T is always greater than 2. So here, t is greater than 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. So x is always less than 1 third. This is the domain of this function. The range of this function is that t is always greater than 2. This means this one is always positive number. So y is always greater than 0. So this is the range of this function. Question number 4. When we have a curve C has parametric equation, x equal to 3 over t plus 2 and y equal to 2t minus 3 minus t squared. T belong to R. T not equal to 0. Determine the range of x and y in the given domains of t. When t is 10 to infinity or minus infinity, x will be 10 to 2. So therefore, because x is not equal to 2 and x belong to R, we take y equal to 2t minus 3 minus t squared. Derivative 1 times by t dy by dt is equal to minus 2t plus 2. So let minus 2t plus 2 equal to 0, t is equal to 1. And at this point, y is minimum or maximum. And we derivative one more time, d squared y by dt squared, we got negative 2. It's a negative number. That means at this point, y is the maximum. When t equal to 1, y is maximum. And when t equal to 1, we substitute t equal to 1 into this equation here. We got 2 times 1 minus 3 minus 1 squared. So we got 2 minus 3 minus 1. This means it's negative 2. So y maximum is negative 2. Therefore, we got y is less than or equal to negative 2. B part, show that the Cartesian equation of C can be written in the form y equal to a multiplied by x squared plus bx plus c over x minus 2 to the square. And we have to find the value of a, b, and c. We got t equal to 3 over x minus 2, so y is equal to 2t minus 3 minus t squared. We substitute everything into here. We got 2 multiplied by 3 over x minus 2 minus 3 and minus 3 over x minus 2 to the square. And we have 6 over x minus 2 minus 3 x minus 2 over x minus 2 minus 9 minus x minus 2 to the square. We make the denominator the same and we got 6 x minus 2 minus 3 x minus 2 square minus 9 over x minus 2 to the square. And we expand it all out. We got 6x minus 12 minus 3x minus 2 to the square minus 9. We got x minus 2 to the square at the bottom. And also we expand these terms out. We got 6x minus 12 minus 3x square minus 4x plus 4 minus 9 over by x minus 2 to the square. Expand this out and add them together. We have minus 3x squared plus 18x minus 33 over x minus 2 to the square. And we take the minus 3 out. So it's equal to minus 3 multiplied by x squared minus 6x plus 11 over x minus 2 to the square. So we have the form is equal to a x squared plus b x plus c x minus 2 to the square, where a is equal to 3, b is equal to minus 6, and c equal to 11. We got the value a, b, and c as well. Question number 5. A diagram shows a curve C with the parametric equation. We got this diagram here. It's from x and y. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one, of course, is 0 here. X equal to 3 square root t, y equal to t to the square minus 2t, and t is from 0 to 2. Find a Cartesian equation of the curve in the form y equal to fx and state the domain of fx. So we got x equal to 3 square root t, you got square root t equal to x over 3. You got t is equal to x squared over 9 here. We have here y is equal to t cubed minus 2t. Y is equal to t multiplied by t squared minus 2. You got t is equal to x squared over 9, so t squared is equal to x to the power 4 over 81 here. We take 9 to the square is 81. So we have y equal to t squared minus 2. So it's y is equal to x squared over 9 times x to the power 4 over 81 minus 2. And we have x to the power of 6 over 729 minus 2x squared over 9. And if we want to calculate the domains of this function, when t is equal to 0, x is equal to 3 to the square root 0 is equal to 0. When t is equal to 2, x is equal to 3 multiplied by square root 2. So the domain of this function is that x is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 3 square root 2. This is the function of fx, and this is the domain of this function. So that's dy by dt is equal to 0 when t is equal to square root 2 over square root 3. We got dy by dt is equal to 3t squared minus 2. And if t is equal to square root 2 over square root 3, we got y over square root 3. If we t equal to square root 2 over square root 3, dy by dt is equal to 3 multiplied by square root 2 over square root 3 minus 2. So is this is square minus 2. So we got is 3 multiplied by 2 over 3 minus 2. We got 0 here. So we prove that dy by dt is 0 when t is equal to square root 2 over 3. Question C here, hence determine the range of fx. So when dy by dt is equal to 3t squared minus 2 equal to 0, fx is minimum. We know that fx is minimum, not maximum, because you have seen this curve here. Fx is equal to the minimum point. So this is the minimum point when dy by dt is equal to 0. So we have here, therefore, when t is equal to square root 2 over square root 3, fx is the minimum point. So fx is equal to square root 2 over square root 3 power of 3 minus 2 times square root 2 over 3. So it's equal to square root 2 over square root 3 multiplied by square root 2 over 3 to the square minus 2. So we got it to the square is square root 2 over square root 3. This one is 2 over 3 minus by 2. So we have square root 2 over square root 3 and 2 minus 6 over 3. And we have here is minus 4 square root 2 over 3 to the square root 3. And we multiply the numerator and the denominator by square root 3. We got here is minus 4 square root 6 over 9. So when t is equal to 2, the fx is maximum. From this curve here, we know that when t is equal to 2, this fx, this y should be the maximum point here. So we got when t is equal to 2, fx is maximum. So fx is maximum when t equal to 2 minus 2 equal 8 minus 4 equal 4. That means that this function here, the range of fx is from minus 4 square root 6 over 9 to the maximum point y is equal to 4. This is the range of the function fx. Question number 6. A curve C has parametric equation x equal to t crib minus t, y equal to 4 minus t squared, and t is belong to r. Show that the Cartesian equation of C can be written in the form x squared equal to a minus y multiplied by b minus y to the square, where a and b are integers and to be determined. So we got x equal to t multiplied by t squared minus 1. So x squared is equal to t squared minus 1 to the square. And we have y is equal to 4 minus t squared. Therefore, we have t squared is equal to 4 minus y. We substitute 4 minus y into this equation. We have x squared equal to 4 minus y multiplied by 4 minus y minus 1 to the square is equal to 4 minus y, 3 minus y to the square. And this is the form of a minus y multiplied by b minus y to the square, where a is equal to 4 and b is equal to 3. Part B, write down the maximum values of y coordinate for any points on the curve. So y is equal to 4 minus t squared. So dy by dt is equal to minus 2t. So let minus 2t is equal to 0. T is equal to 0. The y is the maximum point here. When t is equal to 0, y is maximum. How we know y is not the minimum? Because when you take one more derivative, d square y dt square is equal to minus 2. This is the negative. That means this one is equal to 0, should be the maximum point of y. Therefore, when t is equal to 0, y is maximum. So y is equal to 4 minus 0 square is the maximum point of y is equal to 4. Therefore, we get the maximum values of y is 4. That means y is less than or equal to 4.
Muchas gracias. Again, thank you very much for listening to my tutorial videos. And if you need a private tutor for you to get a better mark or better score in your DSE examination in Hong Kong, the SAT examination, or just you want to improve your mathematics and English for your college and university study, please contact me at qingtong929@yahoo.com.hk. My telephone number is +1 852 659 28609. 好多谢大家收听我这个 video。如果你希望你的 mathematics 和你的英文是更加好的话，你想要一个 private tutor 啦，你可以隨時 contact 我的，令到你的 DSE exam 或者你想考 SAT 你也都可以 contact 我，因為我都有一些私人的補習在這兩方面的。多謝大家， Thank you, bye bye, muchas gracias.